Another hat here, Sindarin, along with a taste from Game and Gladiators. Oh, we get to see Quinn. I believe they said that's his first time playing Primal Beast in this tournament.
Yeah, I think so.
And probably ever, right?
According to you, he never plays anything. And so we get a Morphling. I'm so excited.
Yeah, that's the only downside, right?
We've been casting this hero to death these last 2 weeks.
Well, Duraccio has also been dying a lot on the Morphling early.
One more game will do.
Can he dodge death itself? So you're going to see a battle for the Bounty Rune in the bottom river. And never mind. LGD just going to
quite the battle. It was Why You Smile against Freddy the Frog and Why You Smile 1 and got the rune.
Not so. Freddy again. So yeah, talk to me about this position 1 Brood.
Yeah, it looked like Gaming Gladiators were assuming that it was going to be carry rather than mid based on their last phase bans, right? They were banning mid heroes, so they were expecting Shiro to play the Brood and not Nothing to Say. I mean, it makes sense. The only team in this tournament that really played mid Brood was Evil Geniuses on C-Smile. It doesn't really feel like it was going to fit the bill for NTS, but... Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm just as curious as you are. I don't exactly know how this hero is going to work out. I feel like the matchup against Morphling should not be particularly great. He can get Ags, steal your attack speed, get webs, and just run you down.
Yeah.
And on top of that, you're playing against the Spirit Breaker, which the panel talked about at length, how this hero is very good against Brood in particular, but it's a carry Brood and a 5 Spirit Breaker, so maybe that changes the dynamic a little bit, because what usually happens is when you play Brood in the offlane, the Spirit Breaker position 5 or 4 is going to flank and come in behind you and attack you. That's a lot harder to do in the bottom lane. You can take the gate and maybe find an angle once in a while, but he's got some decent protection, and there's going to be so much pressure on Duraccio top that I don't know if Celery actually even gets to leave. That lane is very tough to begin with.
Yeah, so I'm going to put a time limit on this for you, Sindarin. Okay. You choose. At what point does LGD need to have a barracks in their favor this game?
Because
I think we both agree, if it, let's say it's 35, 40 minutes and they don't have one, I cannot see how they could possibly win. I mean, there's... I'm not saying it's impossible.
I think
game
LGD
has to be favored.
I definitely think LGD can win at any stage in the game, but I think if they want to win late game, Puck needs to be really fun. This hero is a good late gamer, but it needs to have a lot of items to be a good late gamer. And I mean, we've talked about Brood and its shard and stuff, right? Like the hero, like the mindset that Brood completely falls off, I think might be a little bit outdated. And I'm curious again to see if. How much it influences things that it is to carry.
I don't think she falls off, but you are playing as Morphling.
Yeah, yeah. That matchup is going to be tough, and that's where the Puck and Axe need to come up big if it's late game. But I'm not really going to put a time limitation on LGD and be like, okay, if you guys down to Rex minute 40, you're screwed, or minute 30 or whatever. But I think what they would like to do, I think the goal is probably to look to really dominate from minute 20 to 30. I think that's where their lineup has its first peak. And if they can execute well during that, then they'll probably be fine. For Gaiman, I think it's kind of a similar story in the sense that in that time span where LGD's lineup wants to peak, the Gaiman Gladiators lineup should have some pretty good tools. You should have 2 auras on Darkseer. You should have Primal Beast with a BKB. You should have Morph Ags. So if you can stand that test, then you're going to be fine, I think.
See Newt trying to pull these creeps so that he can get some free farm in this lane. And Duraccio trying to disrupt that, and he does. Gets the deny as well as the charge coming from the other side. So the double team onto Newt. And the blood grenade there as well. I mean, Celery will get first blood. Planet trying to get some sort of a trade here. Doesn't have the arcane bolt.
Yes, fairy
Concussive
fire.
Concussive shot. And another fairy fire for Celery. And he actually loses vision, so Celery will actually live. Pretty big investment there for Planet. A lot of time, a couple blood grenades, etc. Meanwhile, mid lane, we see Quinn sitting on 16-2. Nothing to say on 19-2, so pretty damn even so far. Do you think it should be even? All things considered equal?
Yeah, I think that mid lane matchup in general is fairly even. Both heroes kind of farming, and it's hard for either of them to kill the other, because if Puck goes on Primal, he can charge away, and if Primal goes on Puck, there's Phase Shift, there's Orb, there's all 3 spells. Mm. on puck give you disengage opportunities. So you're both going to largely just be spell farming and then getting water runes. So it's a pretty straightforward lane. Charge onto Neo again. We'll take some damage.
And what do you think of the Clink support? This is something we saw a lot of in the earlier portions of the patch, and it's kind of fallen off completely.
I mean, it seems like a direct counterpick to Chen, right? That's the reason they grabbed it.
Okay.
I don't know exactly how and when this power dynamic, like really how it comes into play. Obviously in the early stage with eating the creep with Death Pact is what you're looking for. That's the whole idea. But I guess later in the game when Chen starts getting auras in an army, I don't think Clinks is particularly good against him. Like you
but
can take
can
out
eat
one
two. Delicious creep.
Yeah. It's definitely not bad.
So he needs level 3 to get the two charges.
Maybe it just is better than I'm thinking. Maybe it's just good the whole way. That's possible.
And when it is level 3,
I haven't really seen it much, so.
The creep level that you can eat is 6, which I don't really know the creep levels that well, but I assume
I think that's
but the Ancients.
Yeah, I think that's all of them. I think 6 is the highest money.
Oh, nice
that's
call
a really
from
good
you.
Call.
Counter Helix, pretty ham there on the ham, man. That's a cow joke, of course.
Yep.
But Celery will live and be able to charge back at any point.
Hams generally are from pigs, though. But
that's true.
It's a
boar pig.
Yes.
It's a boar pig cow space.
Defies the rules of meat.
Celery's a vegan, though, so yeah. It matters not.
That makes a lot of sense, then. He's charging Shiro. Ace
they
level,
have vision
five,
in the
level
trees.
4 only, so 2 in the Iron Chill.
The Lotus Pool. Blood Grenade is there. Ace.
Nice vac.
It's off the vacuum, and the Iron Chill looks like it's going to be enough.
Nice
kill from Gaiman.
That's very surprising. And they've also killed Planet in mid. Quinn killing that guy off. And off to a good start here on Gaiman Gladiators in the early laning stage. And that's what you're hoping for, really, with this kind of lineup. Okay, the charge coming in for nothing to say. He does not have phase shift skilled, so this will connect, but it was after Quinn had already backed off.
I wonder if Phylactery will be the build for the Clinks. We saw a lot of that again earlier in the patch. The Tar Bomb synergized pretty nicely.
Yeah.
Get that extra slow. As he's going to be stacking creeps now, as you can see, Quinn shows up at the top lane looking for the kill onto New, but TP is coming. Pulverize is going to be there though, waveform as well. You get silence mid Pulverize though, so that third proc does not connect. And Ace in the meantime, is he actually going to die to this? Shiro continuing to pursue. Blood Grenade is going to connect. And Shiro does find Ace, so gets revenge.
Shiro off to a very slow start on that Carry Brute. He desperately needed to find a kill here to try to catch up. Despite having that kill, he's still way behind the Morphling by 700.
Yeah, not that position 1 brood is all that common, but I would assume a brood against Darkseer can be a bit annoying. I mean, you do have sustain, though, with both the webs and insatiable hunger.
Yeah, it's not too bad, I think, but the overall harass of that lane is just annoying to deal with.
Mm. He's getting charged under the tower. I don't know if Celery's going to commit. He will.
Oh, straight into the crystals he goes.
Indeed. Shiro able to terrain walk away. Wayu Smile's going to show up, though, and Tofu's going to eat his creep immediately. The counter. Clink support.
Yeah. So, from my perspective, this is the best time for Clinks to be against Chen, is these first 10 minutes. And obviously, this was something PSGLGD were not prepared for in the draft. They didn't ban it. They didn't consider it, perhaps. Oh,
Coil mid lane. Nothing to say. Finds himself a Clinksy Clinks. We'll be able to... I think he killed himself.
It did snap in the end there.
And Planet, he's going to get gone on by Quinn. So it's a 1-for-1 on the supports. Yeah, I feel like if you don't snap that, you die to the support instead of the mid.
Yeah,
that case,
that's true. Right? Could have maybe died to the Skyrath. But either way, he was trying to play to the absolute limit, and then the moment it expires, be able to try to run and... Mm-hmm. Just misjudged it by a tiny little bit there. Yeah, the best news for LGD in this game, nothing to say, is having a great time. He's 1,000 ahead of Quinn somehow. I'm actually very surprised. that the gap has grown that big, but obviously Quinn has been moving quite a bit, and that's the trade-off that he's been helping other lanes, and Gaiman should overall be pretty comfortable with the position that they're in particular because both of their side lanes are doing this well. The Darkseer and Morphling, heroes that put early net worth to very good use around the time that PSGLGD's lineup is meant to shine. Yeah. Especially the Darkseer not suffering, I think, is going to be massively important.
Tasty treat.
Nice. Bounty rune still exists.
Who would have thunk? He's going to leave a shitty creep there. I love doing that as well.
Yep. Enjoy.
It's probably going to be them that tries to farm that at some point, and they're going to screw themselves. As rune will spawn bottom. It's a shield rune. Nothing to say. Will be able to get it, it looks like.
Yeah.
Although the charge is coming. Will Illusory Orb and jaunt away. McQuinn continuing to pursue. There's still phase shift, though, and Celery's
actually used the shield rune in anticipation. Not sure what he was really scared of there. Could have just phase shifted the charge, and that would be the end of it.
Don't worry, it lasts 75 seconds.
That's true. He's going to have it until the next rune spawns.
What is the... Why would it be 75 seconds?
That's a good question.
I think everything else about it I'm fine with, though. Just the duration.
I also think it's too strong. But that's just my opinion, man.
Your opinion sucks.
Oftentimes, yes.
Huh. At least you're self-aware. There's a smoke now from LGD to try to get some wards down, potentially a kill. They're going to right into Tofu, though. Ancient Seal.
Yeah, some big spell bend damage burst here.
And he actually will use Coil just to ensure.
Yeah, if he doesn't Coil there, he's afraid that Klinx is going to eat a creep, and then this will drag out and become awkward. So I actually don't mind that Coil at all. Just finish off the kill quickly and get that safety and get out.
So from Shiro, I was going to see what his build was going to be. I assumed it was going to be the same as we've been seeing, mostly as the Harpoon build.
Harpoon BKB. And then it becomes interesting after that. Like, what do you buy against Morph? Do you buy... I guess you don't buy Diffusal. Maybe you buy Nullifier so you can remove... What would you remove with Nullifier, actually? Only Ion Shell and Surge, right?
You'd go Scotty or something, maybe.
Yeah.
Is a universal hero, after all.
Guarantee that he can sticks on his targets. I think Nullifier is going to be important because of this.
Yep, and Surge, very annoying. And Celery also going to be charging in with another strike back into the wall. And here comes Quinn to help finish off the job. Wants all the XP he can get. I helped, guys. But another death for Shiro. And we were questioning the position one Brood. Has not paid off yet. Obviously still quite early, though, as the Blink Dagger now online for Nyu. And nothing to say. He's going to be able to get the Illusion Rune. Quinn not able to contest here.
Yeah.
He uses the Onslaught.
Quinn needs to be careful with doing this, actually, because the Puck is absolutely going to face shift dodge basically every charge unless he's really not paying attention. So if you Onslaught in like this, hoping to get a connection with the charge, you both use your charge abilities, and you could find yourself in a really awkward position where you can get two-man coiled or turned around on by the X dagger that's coming out now. Skywrath also has Mystic Flare, so I think very important to know your limitations here as Primal.
Yep, and they are going to spot the Morphling if they can get the call off. I think this is a death. There it is, but he's next to creeps. Mystic Flare on the outskirts. It's enough, and Nyu chops him up. That is going to be the first Calling Blade stack of the game.
That's a big kill. The top net worth hero on Gaming Gladiator's side.
Yeah,
and they get the tower as well.
They'll get some sort of a trade, although Why You Smile pops the hand of Gaben. And the charge is going to connect, so Why You Smile will die. But the rotation from Nothing to Say, he gets the coil off onto two. More TPs coming in. And the chop not going to be there for Nyu, but they find the kill anyway. And now a call comes out from Nyu, wants to pursue even further. Ancient Seal is going to prevent any Onslaught action. And the Waning Rift is enough. So Quinn takes a tumble. Big kills coming from LGD. They only lose their Chen.
Yep. They ended up not getting the top tower, though, with this rotation from Axe. But I guess the something really important about all this is that they buy space for Shiro, essentially. He could be under a lot of pressure right now from the Klinks plus Spirit Breaker rotations, but if they keep forcing them to try to play defensively around their other cores, then Shiro will get some much-needed recovery here. His game has definitely not been all that great. Still, 1,000 behind the Morphling, but the biggest loser in all of this is still the Primal Beast with a pretty significant disadvantage here.
Yep.
And also worth keeping in mind the supports, right? I don't know how much bang for your buck you get for net worth on Klinks in this game compared to Chen with the perspective we have in mind about when this game is going to peak. So Chen now has the Solar Crest for his team, whereas utility items on the other side, mainly on the
Celery spotted out. Onslaught's coming from Quinn, but the Coil stops him in his tracks. They'll be able to get the cow to start things out, but the Vac Wall with the Tar Bomb to assist. Wayuu Smile's gonna get chased, but Tofu looks to be chopped down, so it's a 2-for-1 as Ace forced to surge away. Should be fine.
Yeah, it's a good wall here. Keeps canceling Neo's Blink, so not able to get any collateral. But he did get the dunk on the Klinks, so a little bit more armor, and Blade Mail now pop for Quinn. This is going to be a very late BKB on the Primal, actually. I think that's the biggest concern here is, you see in these fights, Quinn just gets coiled and his fight kind of ends. So really, really important for him to get there before it's too late. I say that. His other cores are obviously still doing just fine.
I'm trying to remember another tournament where Quinn, it feels like he's lost the mid lane more often than usual. Like, I think he's been like a huge standout for both majors.
Yeah, this
tournament has been a bit underwhelming.
Yeah, he's been challenged a bit more. I also think some games, the overall, like, the flow of the matchups that he's playing have been maybe a bit less favored for him in general. This game, no exception. I don't think Primal in particular is good against Puck, so.
Now the charge onto New. TPs are coming, though. Planet's in the vicinity as well as the Ancient Seal. They're going to get the Nether Strike off onto New on the back line. He's still completely surrounded, but nothing to say. Now how's come with the Coil available, the Vacuum. Mystic Flare's there. They're going to be able to kill off Quinn easily. They get a second on top, they somehow live on New. Ancient Seal still on the Darkseer. Ace is dead as well. Completely punished as LGD. Showing up in numbers.
Did Quinn misclick? He stopped his onslaught.
I saw the onslaught instantly stop, and at first I thought there was a spell that canceled it, like an Ancient Seal maybe, but it didn't catch it.
I think he misclicked and just stopped it, because this should be a clean connection here. There's nothing preventing this from...
He just stopped it. You're right.
Oh, that's such a costly mistake. He's got to be really frustrated with that. This would have absolutely connected on him, and he might not have been able to pulverize because of the Skywrath, but, I mean, look at how little damage they're missing, right? This is just so clean.
I cannot believe he lived.
From LGD. What a turnaround.
Well, nothing to say. This would be a big kill. They're able to get the pulverize off, but the phase shift is there because of the call coming out. And nothing to say will live. Quinn trying to run away now. Nothing to say. Wants to finish the job, and he does so. Game and Gladiators not able to get anything in these engagements. They're down 5k. Celery able to charge away. Their one saving grace is Duraccio's Morphling, who is top net worth in the game right now. And I mean, honestly, Ace is pretty high up there as well. I guess it's just mostly the supports and specifically Quinn. Quinn is actually the biggest net worth discrepancy compared to their counterparts.
Yeah, by far.
Like, a lot of the lead is him, actually.
Yep. It's mainly on mid and position 5, right? The Spirit Breaker to Chen ratio is also very skewed. It's 2.5k there, and on mid it's about 3k. So there you go, that's the 5.
Good job.
Yeah.
Harpoon for Shiro. You assume BKB next, or does he go Manta style?
Yeah, that's what's going to be interesting here is his mindset overall. Because does he think the BKB is necessary and is good enough? Or maybe you just go Lincolns against the Morph Spirit Breaker? That also sounds really good.
Ancient Seal, Battle Hunger, Force Staff into the Berserker's Call. Not able to get the chop off, though. And Neo, only with 2 stacks right now. He's had good opportunity. I mean, he's been involved in a ton of kills, but they just die so fast.
Yeah.
And into the Roche Pit, LGD goes. So this is a 19-minute Roche attempt.
Yeah. Chen is amazing for this. Penitent's one of the best Roshan skills in the game. Do that together with the Army and Brood.
Looks to be a freebie for LGD. And assuming Aegis will be on the puck, but maybe not. You think Shiro is the better hero to have it?
Yeah, I think so. Just put it on Shiro. So keep in mind, Chen with the shard, with every level of his ult, Klinks becomes less and less of a counter, right? So effectively, this counter pick from Game Gladiators is kind of starting to time out to an extent, because he'll have the one ancient now. On level 12, he'll have the two, and Klinks will never be able to eat those.
Yeah,
and those will be the most impactful creeps that Chen has. So you'll have, like, let's say he has a Granite Golem and a Thunderhide for his Brood or whatever. He can rely on those for the rest of the game. Klinks is not going to be able to deal with them in general. So definitely liking that.
There's a Thunderhide that he's going to kill.
Yeah, he won't take that yet. He needs level 12. I think the Granite Golem is overall the more important creep. You just really want to have all of that burst of health for your teammates to survive the vacuum wall, to survive the pulverize. 17% bonus health is really nice.
So, man, I'm trying to... Is it 30 minutes? We've had this conversation. 30 minutes is when the last level gets unlocked for Chen.
So, yeah.
So it's 15:30 then.
Yeah, I believe so.
0:15:30, technically.
Yeah.
I like that mechanic, though. I think that's very cool. There's a smoke now from PSG-LGD. And actually wrapping around, they're going to run right into Quinn and Tofu. Tofu's going to be the first spotted. Quinn will run away.
Oh!
TPing. Woo. That was pretty close.
Yep. But the problem here for Gaming Gladiators is they've really run out of pacing, right? Like, the game seems extremely slow. You want your Spirit Breaker and your Primal Beast to play aggressively, but they feel like they can't take the fights anymore. So they're going to resort to farming for a while. And you just get the feeling that PSG-LGD are going to find opportunities based on that. This is an Aegis Brood. This is not happening. Just trying to force rotations here, Celery, but nobody's going to react. There will be a pipe now for Ace. Will be a big help against the initial burst damage of Puck in these fights, so that's definitely helpful.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised he hasn't. I mean, maybe it's next. The Crimson, I feel like, would definitely be good for Gaiman. Or is that not the case against all these summons?
It's definitely... I would say it's definitely worth it. But at the same time, I'm assuming Brood is going to go Nullifier, right? I'm assuming that. It's no guarantee. Maybe he prioritizes something else. That's still my biggest question mark in this game is how do you itemize carry Brood?
Oh, that Tormentor was taken out, did we? I don't think we caught that.
Tofu got the shard.
Okay.
So that is the Burning Barrage. Not particularly great.
That's terrible.
When you're playing support.
Yeah. Planet will get his, so tankiness, effectively.
I mean, it's still... The Burning Barrage still applies the slow from Tar Bomb. It's not... It's not that bad, but...
Yeah, I'd have to look at the comparison between the old Burning... Like, what level is this equivalent to? I'm not even sure.
Level 1-ish.
Really?
Yeah, wasn't the old one like... What was the other one? Maybe. Was it 55 plus 10 per level? So then it was level 2, maybe.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm trying to remember.
I mean, it was between that and, I guess, the Spirit Breaker.
Yeah, so which also isn't particularly great here.
Yeah.
Quinn not gonna make it.
Oh, coil canceling the TP. Another death for Quinn incoming.
Yeah,
and nothing to say, just getting the better in this game.
Such insane reach. Orb, blink, and coil is effectively an initiation range of like 2.5k and or even more, 3k. And he needed basically all of that to get there in time.
Well, the good news for Gaiman is he almost does have his BKB, a couple hundred away. Of course, they do have Berserker's Call if they find the jump during a pulverize or something like that.
And this Ags on Duracho has to be what does it, right? Like, you need to turn into Brood. You need to have a big fight on Morph. It's really that simple. The rest of the team do not have enough damage anymore. Shiro with the Lincolns as expected here together with the Harpoon. It's very tanky. Does a lot of damage. And they have the sustain from the Chen. They have the coverage of the Axe and the Puck. So going to have to It is really just can Duracho come up big enough. I think that's what we're looking at here. They need to do their best to set him up to turn into Brood, give him good targets to go on.
Onslaught's coming for Shiro.
20 seconds on Aegis.
Yeah,
Aegis
almost out, but the Berserker's call is there. But it looks like Quinn will be the first to fall with the Mystic Flare, but a big Vac wall comes in. Niu's going to be able to run away. Shiro trying to get to the high ground. The Aegis is consumed. Pretty close to expiration date anyway, like you said. Now the Lincolns has popped. Trying to find some space. The waveform's going to find him temporarily. With all this terrain walking, it's going to be tough to follow. Although Duracho turns into the spider. Maybe Niu's going to be the one they find, although Quinn is going to get jumped on by both Niu and Shiro. Charge comes in to disrupt this as Niu will finally go down. Quinn with the trample. Looks like one more right click will do it, but he's actually going to live for once this game. Quinn lives and they get two core kills.
That's big. That was going to be a dieback. They really committed to that with the Axe Brute jump, but not enough resources. Axe died too quickly. Now they're going to get an extra one, so...
Indeed.
Gaming Gladiators, this could be the start of a comeback. Some pretty meaningful kills there. They went from being down 8 or 9k to the 6, and now also getting this tower will cut it down to 5. And that was LGD's choice, right? They were actually disengaged there with their Brute Axe, and they bit over a bit more than they could chew, so... This is going to cost them dearly, and that's a very, very big punish. This tower is also going down.
And now the BKB is up for Quinn. He actually didn't even have it that fight. I'm surprised they fought with, I think it was like 100 gold away at that point.
Yeah, despite buying back, he can still afford it now because that fight had such a good outcome for him. It's a very slow one, as you can see. He's been having a tough game, but... This game suddenly feels a lot more possible for Gaming Gladiators after that one moment.
Yep.
And they are running into the problem of killing the Morph, right? Like, when Duracho pops everything, it's very difficult for them to stand up to him until Puck has a lot of items. So the challenge for PSGLGD is to navigate fights without... Like, you can kill the Morph with a Blink Blademail Axe if he gets to stick. But obviously, Gaming Gladiators will be covering quite a lot. And now... Nothing to say with the Yules as well as Lincolns. This is a very defensive build. He needs to get some damage out there. He needs some Kai Assange, Dagon 5 or whatever. Octarine. Needs some more in the tank to really output here. He's very survivable, but... Makes, I kind of question if he needed to buy this many defensive items, given the matchups that he has.
Mm-hmm.
I guess the Puck versus Morph matchup can be a little bit tricky if he turns into him. But then at the very least, he isn't turning into Brood. So, that's already something.
He also had no trouble doing so because there is charge always there.
Yeah, they can break the Lincolns anytime.
Lincolns break. Now, why you smile spotted. Celery is going to go through with that. The counter initiation
perfect.
Is there from Niu onto two, but no follow up as of yet. He's going to pop the BKB, the Vac into nothing as Celery taking most of the damage from that Mystic Flare. Pulverized on the BKB, Niu who chops up Celery, now trying to get the hell out of there, but he won't be able to do so. So it's a one for one to start. As Duracho is silenced up, will Manta it off. It looks like the fight will break up here.
My goodness, talk about a perfect call there. He got it off as Darkseer was blinking in, so he got it on both of them. But at the end of the day, Gaming Gladiators are just able to brute force through it with their BKBs and at the very least find the one-for-one trade, which is great for them, right? They killed the core, they lost the support, they get the tower. Still a game in favorite outcome.
Do these webs, I guess they remain, right? For the Morphling? So the entire map is just going to be webbed up.
I actually don't know exactly how this works.
I mean, we can just count them. How many can you have with Brood right now?
I mean, they should have... Technically, they should have different colors on the minimap, right? But they don't.
Yeah, maybe.
They're all green. So wouldn't they be red if they were dire?
Who knows? Oh. Duracho, there's a neutral item there, for God's sake!
Unfortunate. Oh!
Shiro will find it. Thank you. Delicious! Yoink. Tofu wanted to get it. That's unfortunate for somebody. I'm sure Duracho will not be the one left without the neutral item, eventually. Yep, has one. He's like,
Shiro identified that really quickly. He was running over to farm the camp, I think. He didn't have any vision that that happened, but... He just saw that item on the ground right away. Snagged it.
Tofu with an Orchid. It's going to be an annoying one. Another Lincoln's Breaker.
Yep.
Or just a way to take out the Skywrath pretty quick.
Yeah, I think it's the Skywrath you're going to go for with this. The Puck still seems too difficult with the Yules as well as Lincolns. But killing Sky early would be a great opener to the fight for Gaming Gladiators when they can find it. And all it takes is to see him for one moment, then they can charge and kill him with Clanks plus one.
Smoke on both sides. Quinn, you can hear the onslaught, but the initiation onto the Morphling, but a huge vac wall onto four heroes. Now the BKBs are activated. And now Why You Smile and you trying to run away. Don't think they're going to be able to do so. So two dead. Very quick turnaround from Gaming Gladiators off of, honestly, an amazing initiation from Niu. Just wasn't fast enough. And Duraccio getting chased by his Broodmother counterpart. Or the other way around, of course. That made no sense. Tofu dies. Nothing to say. Lincolns has already popped. We'll Illusory Orb away.
So hard to kill. He'll get out. Yeah, so we're starting to see some of the problems that LGD's lineup has here, right? It's a good Blink Blade Mail call with some follow-up, but they don't have the enough burst to kill the Morph. You're going to see the replay here, right? So he finds him off to the side. Didn't even get attribute shift off. Doesn't matter.
Oh, goodness.
Your burst is Puck plus X, but you don't have like a Dagon or something like that to really pierce through that first wall of health. And as soon as Duraccio pops BKB and turns into Broody's full health, he just uses Insatiable Hunger and hits three times.
Yep.
And he's back up. So this matchup.
Old Water Boy.
This matchup's just too strong for the Morph when he gets to do this. Chase is so
old. Oh, yeah, the minimap does show red dots.
Yeah, so I think he loses the webs when he turns in and loses the form.
I mean, that could be a way to make it better for Shiro. He gets like twice as many webs on the map. They're just permanent.
Oh, if they worked for anyone who is a spider.
Well, yeah, it's just like Faceless Void's Chrono. When it's stolen, you can still walk around in Rubik's Chrono as Void, right?
Yeah, I think it works differently with webs, though. So if Duraccio turns into the Brood and makes webs, he's the only one who benefits. Hmm. I don't think the Brood shares the web with you.
I mean, that doesn't make that should work that way.
I believe
it's a web.
I believe it doesn't. I'm not 100%
spiders
on that, but
benefit from each other's web, Valve! It's the Aegis and Cheese claimed by Gaming Gladiators who have clawed their way back in this game.
Aegis on the Morph, he's just not the target anymore. They could like maybe kill him once before if they did it perfectly. Now it's no longer the case. So you gotta focus on the other heroes, and now Quinn. After having a really rough game, we're approaching a heart for him now. So he's going to be a hard takedown. And now we're getting to this classic stage that we've talked about many a time. Three tanky cores, Darkseer, Primal, and Morph. Who do you go on? SPSP LGD. With your Axe, with your Puck, nobody feels like a good engage. You might be forced to now already, though. Gaming Gladiators are kind of threatening to go high ground.
Yeah,
Realize that threat.
And some pressure being mounted now in the tier 3 bot. Ace gonna hide behind the trees. The surge into the vacuum. Wall is placed. It's not a big one, though. But they will be able to claim the Skywrath, but the counter initiation from Niu is there. Blade Mail popped along with the Berserker's Call, but he's just gonna get pulverized. Doesn't do much damage during the BKB. But Niu will be cleaned up very easily as Chen creeps finally come to assist in this defense. But they've lost their Axe. Niu does have buyback, though. This is looking more and more like a lane of Rax, though, for Gaming Gladiators. The coil is down. As there's a big vacuum charge to come, trample as well. The Chen is the recipient of most of the damage, but he might be able to live through this. Pulverize, no cancellation coming out. So YU Smile is in the grave, and Shiro and company have to reside in their fountain as they just have no damage on LGD's side now. And Duraccio turns into the spider, and now his sights set on the next set of racks in the mid lane.
Yeah, that really is the summary of what's happening right here. They're just out of damage.
That's a lot of webs.
Wow, he's trying to lag the server. They all despawn. Tipped by Ace. Yeah, they're just watching Duraccio win the game.
Yep.
They can't go on the Morph. They can't kill him.
Oh, they're going to initiate, but yeah, Niu's going to want to die there as the vac, or the wall, I should say, being placed again. And I think LGD have just run out of steam in this game number two.
Yeah.
It's now a Satanic online for Duraccio. Yeah, I think you're right. GG's going to come out. Puck just didn't have the damage. I like new thing, like weird things that LGD bring to the table. I don't understand what the point of the Brood position one was, though. Like, it could have literally been any other hero.
And maybe...